guys. This is Mark McDonough, your Sacramento Realtor. We're talking Sacramento real estate. I'm here with Kaelee. We're going to be talking a little bit about giving you a Sacramento real estate market update right now. What's going on? What is it, like the 21st of April, 22nd? I'm losing track. How you doing?
I'm great. I'm so happy it's Friday. I'm doing good.
Is it Friday?
Huh. I think. Pretty sure. Who knows?
So what are you seeing out there, Kaelee? Come on. What are you seeing out there in the title world? What are we looking at?
Oh, well, things are interesting right now, I would say. We had an amazing webinar with Ryan Lundquist. I'm never going to stop referring to him. Sacramento appraiser, runs Sacramento appraiser blog. And he just gave us some really amazing up-to-date look at the data of what is happening in Sacramento market. And there's some interesting things that I saw that are really reflective in our escrows as well. And the first thing I think that was really interesting to me is that since April 1st in the Sacramento area, 44% of all homes that were listed had multiple offers, which is kind of crazy because I think when you look at the headlines and you listen to a lot of that negative chatter and dialogue, you think that the real estate market is doing what the economy is doing and it's at a complete halt. And this is just evidence, you know, it's the objective data that you can't argue or have an opinion about. I guess you can have an opinion about it, but it shows us that the market is still moving. And while our listings are down 32% from last year, we're still starting to see this rise. So, I mean, over the last 2 weeks, we've started to see an increase in listings and we've started to see those multiple offers. And it's really also kind of at that sweet spot price point too, the $300,000 to $500,000 range. And I think that we're just going to continue to see that. I think that we're in this area where people have gotten comfortable with the shelter in place. You know, there's nothing more that's going to keep us going down. It's only up from here. We're going to start seeing restriction easements and all that. So I think that's all going to fuel to the number of listings continuing to rise. And I think that's going to be the interesting part where there's a little bit of a shift where as the listings start to rise, I think that we might see a little bit more of a stop or a hold on the buyer side where you'll start to have more seller concessions. You'll start to see more buyers that aren't really interested. And I think that's just because coming out of this, you'll see more people that are needing to liquidate and more people that also need to hold on to their money because of, you know, being in 6 to 8 weeks of not making any money. So it's hard to say what exactly is going to happen, but based off of what we're seeing right now, I think there's a good chance of it becoming more of a buyer's market in the next few months, but we'll see. We'll see.
All right. Yeah, no, I agree with you. And Ryan is just the man when it comes to the stats and knowing his stuff. Here's what I'm going to say. And here's something that a lot of people haven't really touched on, but I want to just stand on my soapbox and preach a little bit about this thing for a brief second.
Do it.
The American people are resilient. What we're seeing right now is that we're adapting to virtual tours. We're adapting to what's going on right now in our marketplace. It's reflective on the stats and I get it, you know, like of course there's like a reason for that, but I will also throw in that idea that we're adapting. We're not waiting for this thing to be over to get going in selling and buying. We're adapting to what's out there because we know that right now there might not be an end in sight for a little while. So right now what you're seeing is people adapting to it. People are saying to themselves, wow, things are still selling. There are buyers out there. Interest rates are low. We can actually get around this by doing certain things. Safety precautions, virtual tours. Giving a shout out to a lot of the real estate agents out there who are kind of stepping up and saying, look, my client really needs to sell the house. I mean, he really needs to, and to do it for them. You know, interest rates are low. It's keeping the buyer pool somewhat decent right now. And there's buyers to actually make multiple offers on houses, which is cool. You know, I do agree with you. I think what we're going to see is home prices are going to taper a little bit off, but I don't think we're going to see that drastic whoom. I think it's going to taper a little bit. And I think what we're going to see is as the buyers kind of flood into the market again, it might all of a sudden rise again towards the end of the year. You never know. But I will give a big shout out to everyone out there. I mean, I honestly, myself, I was thinking to myself, a lot of people wouldn't adapt, but I'm seeing people like some of the people out there who are like, you know, on a global level selling real estate, adapting to the virtual tours, selling stuff. Things are moving. I think right now we're getting a little stir crazy. We're feeling a little claustrophobic. We're maybe on too many Zoom calls, and it's getting to us. But I do think that we're adapting to a new way of doing things. And instead of waiting for this thing to be over, we're saying to ourselves, okay, look, what's the best way we can go forward? Because there is no end in sight for this at this moment. You know, like, so I give props to the realtors out there, the mortgage people, title companies. I mean, we're doing the best we can, and we're adapting, and we're growing, and we're developing. And now we're seeing it, like Ryan said, you know, and everything. There's more pendings. There's more listings. It's slowly creeping up, which is cool. I like it. I mean, so, you know, I'm being as awesome optimistic as I can in this market, because the signs that I'm seeing are pointing to us becoming a little bit more adaptive to our market. So I like that.
Yeah. I mean, I think you're 100% right there. And I think Darwin would be proud of the human species. Yes, right now, would. Right? It's adapt or die always. And this has been one of the most pressing situations for us to really showcase how we can do that. I think in the real estate industry, it's been incredible to see how many people were able to really transition and embrace this new way of doing business virtually, right? And that also kind of is a perfect segue into what we as Cornerstone have been doing. We have this campaign that we started called our Bounce Back Campaign, based off of, you know, everything that we're seeing, the data and the just the activity from people in our industry. And, you know, from the industry leaders too, we're hearing all of these really optimistic views about what the other side is going to look like, you know, when we come out of this. And so one of the things that we are trying to do is really support our partners, the realtors and the lenders out there, and say, what are you doing right now that is going to put you in the position to be on the top curve of that bounce back? Because if you're not doing anything right now, when that bounce back starts to happen, you're going to be sitting there watching it all happen, and it's not going to be involving you. So what, you know, there's all these sayings like what you do today dictates what you'll be doing in 100 days. And I think that is more true than ever. You know, what are you doing right now? So for me in particular, my role in the agent and lender's life right now is strategy. What are we doing? What are you doing right now for your marketing, for your farming? And it's really interesting because I think there's this kind of old age perspective of farming. When I say that word, people are like, oh, I don't, you know, it doesn't work, or I don't have the money to spend on that. And I think that there's this, you know, traditional look of the farming of, it just means pick a geographic area and start sending out a bunch of stuff and dominate that area. And what I'm trying to bring to light for people is that farming can be so much more specific and targeted. So right now I'm sitting down with people and I'm saying, what buyers are you working with? What listings are you have that are sitting on the market? And let's target the specific property that that buyer needs that's not available. Or let's target the specific buyer that your listing needs that you can't find right now. And let's start soliciting them like crazy. And we have had so much response because it's not some, you know, carte blanche postcards that we're sending out. We're actually sending out letters that are personal and relevant to the person who's receiving them. And I get success calls all the time with these stories of, you know, oh my gosh, I just got the most amazing response. And you know, I have agents right now who don't have anyone that they're working with. And so they are going out and doing these amazing things within their own neighborhood and getting amazing response, you know, dropping off seeds, giving them something beautiful to look at. And really putting that humanity first before the realtor, I think, is having incredible response right now. So if you aren't doing anything, or if you feel like what you're doing is not enough, reach out to your title rep, reach out to me. Let's strategize and make sure that you are at the top of the curve when we start this bounce back.
Yeah, I mean, one of the things I do love about the way Kaelee works as well is like, a lot of people are scared of videos, and I get that. I mean, videos are, you know, just not that you know, it took me a while to actually even get on camera. But when you work with someone like her, she can guide you in ways of doing stuff online, things at work. The thing that's nice about working with a good title person as well is because they've worked with a lot of different real estate agents and groups and everything, they kind of know what works, what doesn't work, what things are successful in the market and everything. So I definitely encourage people to reach out to Kaelee. I mean, like I said, I see her all the time online, on Instagram, all this kind of fun stuff. And she's got a really creative way of putting herself out there. And I would say that if you're a realtor right now and you're sitting there on your hands and saying, this is great, but I know there are things that I should be doing, I just don't know what those things are. It doesn't hurt to reach out to Kaelee. Like I said, her information is going to be below in this video, so you can reach out to her directly. Give her a call. She's really awesome. And she can give you some ideas of what you can be doing right now, because she hit the nail on the head. Eventually, this thing is going to come to a close. And eventually, we're going to have this flood of buyers and sellers that are jumping into the market. I know realtors straight up that have clients who have listings that are waiting for this to basically be over. I have a listing. I have actually three listings waiting for this thing to be over to go on the market. So, you know, be ready, because when that hits, and we don't know when that's going to hit, you should have all your ducks in a row, and working with a title person like Kaelee is definitely something that makes sense. Not to mention, you guys are local, right? Roseville?
Yeah, well, we're all over. We have an office in Sierra Oaks in Sacramento, one in Roseville, and then also an office in Elk Grove. And then we have another 14 offices down in the greater Bay Area region. So cool. We're kind of spread all over. We cover the Sacramento area pretty well, I think. And I just want to kind of reiterate what you're saying. You know, people are uncomfortable doing new things, especially this whole video thing, which I hesitate to believe you that you weren't a video guy, because you're so great at it. But what I think where I have the most success is that when I talk to people, I try to figure out what is unique about you, right? We are all unique in some way. And the best results you're going to get is when you're able to figure out what makes you unique and then authentically deliver that, whether it's through video or through letters or whatever you're comfortable with. When you're able to embrace who you are, like you have, Mark, people are drawn to that. They start to really kind of come to you. And when you start doing that right now and getting in front of people, they're going to be drawn to you, so that when we come out of this, you're going to be the person that's top of mind. You're going to be the person that they're calling when they want to buy or list. And that's what I think the best thing that you can do to set yourself up right now.
Yeah, and also if you're a realtor, like someone like me who does a lot of videos and everything, it never hurts to get some new ideas. For me, I'm always looking for new ideas on content, on things other people are doing as well. So, you know, and I do now and again bump into the realtors who are like, yeah, no, I got my stuff going on. But the truth of the matter is, like, if you're not learning and growing and developing and hearing what other people are doing, you don't know exactly if you are going in the right direction. So at least it's good to bounce ideas off people and, you know, and grow and develop. And the only way you can do that is by reaching out to people like Kaelee and figuring out if, you know, if there's anything else you could be doing, because it might surprise you and there could be other things you could be doing. Like this one, we're collabing. This is cool. Yeah. This is fun.
And you might actually enjoy it.
Yes, you might. Like for me, like I love this. I mean, talking to Kaelee, getting her, you know, perspective on it, on the real estate, like Sacramento real estate market, it's awesome, because like I know her viewpoint is different than mine. It's like being in a baseball stadium. Each one has different seats. Hers is like down right by home plate. So she's seeing what's going on. And I'm kind of looking over there going like, I think this is what's going on, but I don't really know the scope. And then we got Matt, the mortgage guy, who comes in from the other angle. So it's good to understand every single angle of every situation you're in. If you don't know all the players, you don't know the game right. So it is what it is. So that's
well
it. Kaelee, thank you once again. Your info is going to be down below, and I'll see you next Friday. Have an amazing day. That's any parting words for our Sacramentians?
If you see someone without a smile, give them one. That's all I got to say.
All right. So that's it. Have a good one. Sacramento Real Estate Update. See ya.